All right, so ladies and gentlemen, I want to say a big welcome to all of you to this call. It promises to be a very deep call to help even people who are veterans in this business on the important things to familiarize yourself about. You will notice that we have some of the people here on the call who are leaders who will be addressing some of your issues, okay? And I'll be giving more chance to the leaders who have shown their faces so that people relate to them, not those who have not shown their faces, because we want this thing to be very professional. All right. So we started a recording. I want to say a big welcome to all of you. So here's the first important thing. Let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen. If somebody joined this project, the person is already humble. The person is usually coachable on the first day. You tell him to do this, he will do. You tell him to do that, he's ready to do. And that is a day you should onboard the person. That is a day you should orientate the person. That is a day you should speak to the person and let the person know all the 15 important things he has to have. 15. Important things the person is supposed to have. You want the person to know about it. If you don't groom that person and you just throw the person onto the page, you have killed the person. You have destroyed the person. You have massacred the person. You don't go back to the person and tell the person after 1 year to renew. He will not renew. There are 15 things you want the person to be aware of. And you want the person to learn to come to an appreciable level. So today we are going to discuss those 15 things, elaborate on them. And if we are not able to finish, we'll continue again on Saturday, as we always do. And I want the leaders to be bringing some of the deep points, the very common mistakes that people tend to do when it comes to this project. The very easy, common mistakes, and the repeated mistakes. Okay. In the process, I'll be showing you some links in there. So let me start with you, Dr. Dorothy Hansen. Could you please tell us the first thing you have observed? You know, I know this afternoon we were talking. The first common mistake that people are doing from the beginning and sometimes even in later times of the business.
Right. Hi, guys. Good evening and welcome. I hope you have your pen and paper by your side, because today you have to take some notes so that you don't make some of these mistakes early. I think, first of all, I think for everybody who signs on, first of all, you have to have that sense that you are a leader, because by and large, you're also going to be signing on other people. So for most people, the process they are taking through, I hope everybody is taking through that process of signing on. The very first thing I do for anybody I sign on is to help the person with their referral link. That's the very first thing the person should own and know how to create it, because they are going to be creating this for the next person they sign on to. And you have to know
just
that
explain
first.
Clearly, so most what people, you mean by this referral link, so that people understand it well.
Just like each and every one of us has a personalized link. The person who signed you on also used a personalized link to sign you on. A link that ends with, that has the person's username in it with gobackup.com at the end. Or a gobackup.tor. Okay, let me, I wish I could type it out somewhere.
It's on the screen.
But there's a link that the person used to sign you on. Good, thank you so much. So once you have signed somebody on, and you yourself signed yourself on to also hope to sign somebody on, you need to know how to do this first. And most of the time, most people will generate it for you, but I will take you through the process of generating it yourself. Make all the mistakes. You cannot edit it. You have to learn how to do it, because that's like the basic thing that will lead the next person to the next step. So I realize most people don't know how to generate the link, even after they have signed on as go back up resellers. You see, once you sign on as a reseller, there's a lot of learning to do. You are a reseller. You are going to learn how to sell to the next person. And you just don't sign on and sit down and expect your upline to be doing that for you. Because when you have found somebody you want to sign on, it's not now your upline is coming in to sign the person on for you. Because in as much as your upline is there to support you, we are all ready to support each and every team member we bring on. I mean, if you call me from Adam about a sign up, I won't be too happy to go through the process, but I'll do it for you. But you have to learn. The next person, if you call me again, I wonder whether you are learning. Each of us must learn the referral link. It's in the GBU manual. That's the very first thing I'll start from. Once you sign someone on, get the person's referral link. And as you can see, it's the point
again,
four.
Still on this referral link, what have you observed that people do? Some of the mistakes people do when it comes to this referral link, apart from what you've said.
So what I've observed is for the new person coming in, let me start from that side. And the person doesn't know what a referral link is to start with. And they need to understand why they need to have a referral link, because it sounds like you just have to get a referral link. But what's a referral link for? So the need and the importance of it should be communicated immediately the person signs on. People don't do that until they have found somebody and they want to sign the person on.
That's
when they start.
That's
ask
a
you,
how, that's a
where's
point.
The link? What is that? What is that? Yeah. So let the person understand the need for this referral link as soon as the person signs on, and help the person to make guess. Don't make it for the person. Help the person to make guess. I hope you know how to make yours. Then you can help the person to make it. Simply put, this is the link. You have a portion that says your own username. So as soon as I, Dr. Dorothy Hansen, my username is Doc Hans. So as soon as I was signed on, I was sent this link, edit it and send it back to me. That's what we mostly do. So we send you the link, edit your own username and send it back. Then the person will confirm. Because this is the same process you are going to be using for each and every person you sign on. So the place that has your own username, you just replace it with your username. Mine is Doc Hans. So as soon as I put Doc Hans in there, the system recognizes that I'm a paid registered member of GoBackup. And I can use
some of the very mistakes people do with this thing when they don't change it. They don't change it at all.
Some people, look, somebody has used gobackup.gobackup.com as his account name. Somebody has used username.gobackup.com as their own account name. So if you are going to just click on it and put your details or use this as it is to sign somebody on, you are signing somebody, your person that you hardly got, you after all the stress, you are dashing the person easily to the person whose URL is username.com.org. So if your username is not in it, you don't share it. So long as your username is not on it, it's not yours. It may be somebody's. And you may be just dashing the person pre-enrollees and new signups. You'll be there, somebody has signed on to him. So you need to own the username. So if you're not changing it and you're just clicking and filling out, you're dashing precious people to a stranger that you don't know. So you need to edit.
That's a word.
Edit and put your username there.
Ladies and gentlemen, you know what people do, Dot? You know what some of them do? Some of us, what we do is that we just copy it like this and send it to our new guy who is coming on board. Like you are copying it like this and pack. Do you know that somebody is in GoBackup right now? The person knows that you will make this mistake. So you know what the person has done? The person has used the word your own username as his username. So when you send this to the person, what happens is that the person will eventually stop. The person will be the one who will take your person, because instead of you editing it, you have used the word your own username, and that is his username. But your username is Dr. Hans. Your username is Dr. KOA. Your username is, you know, something tribe. And yet, Eagles tribe. And yet, you have not put your username there, and you have rather used the word username. It is something we have to, and Dante, not to cut you, I just want to go back to this document. Because whilst you were looking for the thing, I just brought the document. So what would you say about this document?
This document is like the manual for success. It is your manual for success. If you want to succeed in Go Back Up, you have to read through this, not once, not twice. Because sometimes, even me, when I know most parts of this, Dr. Kere keeps updating and adding new stuff to it. Until you go through it, you don't know if you are an old bee. What is new? If you're a newbie, you have to just go through it step by step by step. Make sure what step one says you know it. What step two says you know it. What step three, all the way, plus videos. Videos of trainings we've had in the past. Videos of trainings we just had. Trainings that have the content that you need to build you. It takes probably a week to go through this and master it for the first time. Pace yourself, go through it and make sure you've touched every bit of it. Start watching the videos. Most of the time you say, when will I watch the video? I can't sit down. It is something you have to just listen to. Unfortunately, there's no audio. I mean, listen to it. I listen to these audios when I'm cooking or I'm doing something that is packing and my ears are free so I can listen. So that's when I start tracking on video one, video two. If I catch a point, I pause and go and write it. I have a book, guys. I actually have a book. Let me show it to you. It's always on my desk. Today I'm at my desk. I have a book that I put everything, all the points of everything I've learned. I date it. This is an intentional project. You can't do it by heart. If you intend to succeed, you can't do it by heart. If I forget and I forget something, I remember I had it on a certain page. I come and flip, the points will just be there for me to refer. You have to have a book that you are putting the points in. So don't just read through it. Read and make your own personal notes. It's been updated severally. Trust me, this is not the document we started with. But the more we are growing the project, the more we are learning the things that are working. And like I said, success leaves tracks. Success leaves tracks. If you follow the tracks of successful people, you'll get where they are going. And this is one of the tracks that we have for Go Back Up. And I don't know which other team has a document put together like this to guide the members when they join. We are fortunate to have this document. Dr. K takes time. He wakes up at dawn to put things together, things that come into his head through the plenty troubles we ask him. Look, we are over 600 and something people who call Dr. Kere. Can you imagine? And each time we call, the document is there. The content is there. He remembers something that's not there. He puts it in for us. By then, you and I may be sleeping. But he's up because of us to get this document together for us. So don't play with this document. If you don't have it, ask your team leader for it. It's on the page every single morning. If this maybe is not posting it, somebody else is posting it. It's there every morning because you may have forgotten to look at it. Download it once. When the upload comes, when the upgrade comes, download the upgraded one. There might be something, there's always something new in the upgraded one. This is version 14. I'm sure there's more than 14, but you've done more than 14 upgrades of this, and this is the most recent version. So guys, look at it and go through it. It will help you. It will put your mind in the frame of what will make you succeed. I'm not hyping the document, it's the truth. You can ask anybody who's gone through it, or any of those succeeding, whether they've not read through this document and it's not high helping them. It helps everybody from the first person who got on board to anybody who signs in today and wants to succeed. If you want to be copper this week, if you read through this, you'll be copper this week. And that's just the tool. That's why the Takego has labeled it serial code of practice. If you want to succeed well, you have to go through this document.
Okay. Dorothy, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we've just spoken about 1.0. And look at the time we've already spent. We've spoken about only one point, which is the referral link. Just that in the document. And look at the time we have even spent on that referral link. And I guarantee you, even though we spent time on this referral link, somebody is still going to struggle with it. I'm not talking about even a new person coming. I'm talking about somebody who is here. And the reason is because the person will still not go through this. Ladies and gentlemen, please let me tell you something. I wrote this document. I go through this document every single day. I go through this document. I won't lie to you. That is how serious I see this document. I wrote it. I'm the author of the document, and I go through that document, which I have authored myself, every day. So what do you think you should do if you are not the author of a document? Mm-hmm. And I, the author, go through it every day. And most of the questions people have gone through, Most of the worries people have gone through and have is in the document. Listen, let me share something with you regarding this document. The document is an activity document. It is an activity, which means that as you are reading, you are acting, you are doing. So for example, point number one, you read, there's a website there. It means that you have to stop going to number two until you have watched the videos, the two videos in number one. Is it a thing? So it's an activity. And you have to understand it fully before you go to the next one. If you don't understand, you quickly talk to your upline. You quickly speak to one of the leaders. This is it. This is it. Because you see, a lot of people say, where do I log in? It is number three. It tells you exactly where to log in. And when you log in, it tells you exactly what to do there. So I want us all to take this document and train all the people you will ever register. And please, you yourself, go through the document. Don't wait. Don't wait till you are ready to register before you come and realize that, how do I even register? And I'm going to show you some common mistakes people do when they are registering people in that regard. Okay, so the referral link is an important, important link. Let me see whether there are any of the other leaders here who can pick on something that people have been missing all the time. Abisolo, if you can tell me what has been one of the things you have observed that people are missing in this project. Abisolo, if you can hear me, let me know. Anyanam, if you can hear me, let me know.
Yeah, Prof.
Go ahead, please.
Go Hello, ahead, Prof.
Go ahead, go ahead.
Yes, so one thing I've realized is that most people, after signing up, they even forget their password. Their password. So sometimes you need to send, message to support for them to, help you to reset their password. That's one first thing. Secondly,
please don't go secondly. Let's stay with that. Okay. Why does that happen?
Okay. Yeah, so what I've realized is that most people, like, I think after the registration, they don't keep their password. They don't keep their password in their mind, or they don't write the password somewhere. So they easily forget. Sometimes too, it has been, they were registered by the appliner. I think myself, I made that mistake before. I registered someone. So instead of capturing the password or writing it somewhere or screenshotting it, I thought it's my mind. So immediately I finished, I forgot. And I had to send message to support for them to, help us to retrieve it. So I think one way or the other, we're not putting the password in a good manner, or like putting it taking it serious or anything like that could let us forget it easy.
Okay, Abisolo, let's quickly solve that before you go to point number one, the next point. The
yes.
Solution to this, ladies and gentlemen, is anytime somebody registers, the person should write the password down. If you register someone, send the username and the password to the person's WhatsApp. Because with that one, the person will not forget. If the person forgets, you also have it. You will not forget. In fact, most of the time, people want to hide their password. They want to hide their username. But you see, they don't have importance to the business. The business is not that important to them at that time until they are ready to register someone.
Okay? Yes.
They don't even log in. They don't log in. They don't log in. For example, you cannot register today and not log in today. Because if you are going to log in, you will quickly say, hey, where's my password? So you immediately, that day, you get to know that. So you, the upline, you cannot also register somebody and not help the person to log in. The moment you register the person, give the login link. And when I say login link, it is here. It is a GBE document, point number 3. Give that login link. This is a login link. Give it. There's a video about that, which is here. Give the login link to the person and tell the person, click, type this link into your browser. Click on it. Log in with your username and password. I want to see you do it. The person says, oh, please, please, you, I can do it. I'm driving. I'm that. Park the car. Log in. Because the moment he gets to the office, he will not be able to do that. He will forget. Let the person see. Ladies and gentlemen, this is something that is paid $2,000, $3,000, $5,000, $10,000. You want to treat it well. You want to treat it well. Okay? Because if you don't log in now, you will forget. You will forget even the link to log in is a problem. So I think that because people don't log in immediately, that is why they forget the username and password. Because normally you remember the username and password the moment you register. It is a bit more in your head. But when some days pass by, a day or two, and you are not logged in, that is when the thing becomes. And please, when people log in, let them save it. Let their computer save it. You know, save it on your computer. It's your computer, it's your phone. Save it. Add to your password, Google password, saved. So that in case you forget, you will be able to do that. Please.
Prof.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, so I want to ask you, I know the password, I want to ask this question. So could it be that if somebody signs, for a long time, the person does not log in on time, let's say about 3 weeks to a month, the person does not log in, can the password be changed automatically?
No.
Yes, I don't know. There's one team member I registered. For he, as he, I think, logged in the first day, he never logged in again. But the same password, the same username I gave him to, I mean, open the back office. As of 3 days today, we've tried several times. It's not opening.
I can tell you that it's possible that something has changed.
Yes.
It's possible. Take it from me. I've gone back to the co-CEO on this. And the co-CEO will tell you, you can have all the confidence that that thing is the same thing you did. But watch it. There are two places the person might be trying to log in. If you log in with your password on the back office, you cannot use that same login in your app or your software unless it is highly protected password. So for example, if you are using simple password, it will allow you to log in the back office, but it will not allow you when you are logging in into the app itself. So it's very important. So Abisolo, I guarantee you, it happens that this person may have slightly changed. You said it yourself that the person logged in the first day, but some 3 weeks have passed.
And he's mentioning heaven and earth that he has not changed anything.
Of course.
And now he's...
Okay, the only way we can guarantee this is if the person, on the day he logged in, his Google password software saved it.
Yeah, no, he didn't save it.
Good.
And you know, we sent a message to support. Support gave us a link to open.
Yes.
But the moment you open, it comes back to new like signing in again, new person. But they will tell you he has paid. It won't give you the chance to, change.
No. I know that link. I mean, so let me tell you some secret. That link is not a new person. That link, he has to scroll down to the very bottom and accept that thing that he, you know, he's not a new person. He has to accept it before he will now go as an old person. You see, again, all of this happened because the person has not logged in for a long time. When you have not logged in for a long time, a page is given to you. That makes it look like you are a new person. But you have to scroll to the very bottom. It's just like when you are registering and you have to scroll to the very bottom and then you will see, no, thank you. It's okay. No, thank you. It's okay. That similar thing is what you will get when you haven't logged in for a long time or when your account is suspended and you are renewing it. So that is what a person will have to go. I know that link you're talking about.
All right. So can I move on?
Yeah, go ahead.
So the next problem that I think...
please hold on. I think Kofi Asante has raised his hand so high, it appears he has an emergency question he wants to ask. Kofi, what is your question?
Thank you very much on this platform. I think I just need to add this to this. I think the major problem on these default links is because when a person registers, there's an email that is sent to your email to confirm you've been registered. If you don't do that, that's when the problem starts to come.
Have you encountered this thing before yourself in GoBackup?
Yes. I think when you register and then you are a link you'll be sent to your email just to activate the account from your email. So I think when people register, they are still on their dashboard, but they don't really go back to check their email and confirm from the email again that the link that I was sent to the email has been confirmed. So when they just log out without confirming from the email, that is when in a very long time, if they don't get to log in, this issue comes up. So immediately you create a new page or a new site for a newcomer with the email, I think you need to confirm from your email and that will be it. It doesn't really mean if you really have to log in for a long time or not. All right, thank you.
Okay, thank you. Abisolo, you have another point. Dorothy, please, if there's something somebody has asked in the page in terms of a question, you let us know. Other than that, if it is a statement or a comment, then others can read themselves. Let me go back to Abisolo. Abisolo, continue.
Okay. So the other challenge that most of the, let's say my team members have always been facing is sometimes those using the iPhone. After they've downloaded the app, now the app, you click on it, then it will give you a blank. It won't open. You click on it, then it will give you like, eye blush, bah. Like, hey, so I don't know, like I have about 5 team members who have the same challenge. So the other time, Dr. Dorothy asked them to update their iOS to date. Yes, somebody have even updated several times to even to current one, but still, the app can't stay on the phone. I don't know. Is it because of the type of iPhone or what? Because I still have people who are facing the same challenge. Yesterday, I raised one person. He's facing the same challenge.
All right. Okay. Dorothy will answer you.
So, for everybody, before you use the app on your mobile device, there's no way GoBackup will know the app belongs your mobile device. Someone is putting a funny comment.
I think the issue of probably I don't want to buy it here. Let's get the answers correct.
So there's no way. It's this technology and security is important. Data security is important. So the only way GoBackup will know that this mobile device called iPhone 12 or iPhone 8 belongs to Dr. Dorothy Hansen is when I have gotten into my back office. There's a difference between the back office and the app. For your first,
this will be fully explained during the leadership summit on 7th.
Yeah, if everybody should be there. If you are here, you have to be there, whether virtual or in person, and just register, pay, and catch a seat over there. So for your very first login, you have to. Okay, Yvonne is adding some more. For your very first login, you have to go to your back office first. Go to digital tools. Go to use this to. Click on GoBackup and get to your dashboard. On your dashboard, you see the auto login, Windows login, iPhone login, and then the links to mobile app logins. You see auto login. That's why it shows you 0% and 5%, like how much you've used of your data. But if you're now doing it for the first time, mostly it'll be 0%. So give you 6 terabytes available, and then where you can add an additional account. Okay. So before you use it on your phone, you log into your back office still on the same device, on a browser. And then you go to your app, download the app from the app store or the Google Play Store and use the same username you use on your back office for that app login the first time. Let me take a step back, sorry. So when you've downloaded the app, you do auto login first on your back office, on your browser.
Okay, when you say browser. You do auto login, be clear. What do you mean by you to do auto login?
So, like, okay, so at your back office, when you have
click gotten, on auto login, that's what you mean.
Click on auto login, yes.
Ah, that's it.
Sorry. So you click on auto login at your back office. That puts you into your cloud. Okay, that puts you into your cloud space, your 6 terabyte space. It may be empty. It will be empty at the first open. It will be asking you to add documents. Then you come to the app. At the time you put your username and password, the same username and password, don't change the email address. Don't use a new email address. It is you. Go backup wants to recognize the device that you are using. So most of the time when you do that first login, you would see that it's going to ask you for permission to upload from your mobile device to the cloud. And that's how you get to use it for the first time on your, I mean, I use an iPhone, so I can talk for iPhone. And I guess it works the same way for Android. But note that for most people, this is most efficient on Wi-Fi. Your first login, when it's loading a lot of things, is most efficient on Wi-Fi. So if you're on mobile data, it may not be that efficient. It will look like it's not working.
Please, can you repeat that part? Because people didn't hear that part. That's what 90% of the people make the mistake.
So for your first login, you must do it on Wi-Fi. Otherwise, it will look like the app is not working. The first login, the thing is set to do on Wi-Fi, to upload on Wi-Fi. So after you've done, let me take the 3 steps back. So auto login, click on auto login in your back office in a browser. Then you come to the mobile app, put in your username and your password, the same you use for your back office login, the secure one. Then go back up and recognize the device as it is your device that is trying to log into the auto login section. Okay. Then you must be on Wi-Fi. It works best first upload on Wi-Fi. Otherwise, to do the blinking thing as if it's not working. Some other people use a new username and a new password. Go back up does not know that. What they know is the one that you set up yourself. So when you're on Wi-Fi and you are doing your first login, in seconds, you just see the it starts initially with your photos and videos being uploaded in batches of 50. It will upload, it will gather 50 and upload. It mostly would have summarized how much data you have, 4,000 files. It will just know it just by in a second. Then to start telling you, uploading in batches of 50. So it keeps uploading and uploading. It works okay if you ask, you do it at night. It's not good when you are using your mobile device and if you are active in the day. It will work all right, but if you want to get its most efficient, it's best at night. You set it and leave it to upload well. Okay. I hope it helps because I mean that's right. Just let's upload.
Okay, thank you. Abisolo, does that help with the other comments that we made? Does that help with the understanding?
Yeah, but somebody said that it works on from 10 iPhone 10 and above.
Exactly, which is true.
So it means all those having the 7 and those 10, they should put it somewhere.
No. It doesn't mean they should put it away. They should continue using that. But they cannot use the 10 on those things because the iPhone itself, now we are dealing with iPhone 15. 15. So going back 3-5 years is better, but it looks like the person is going back 7 or 8 years. That is why the person is struggling to be able to use that. Okay. The idea is that it is too old, simple. The unfortunate thing is that it's too old. Sometimes certain things work better. You see, if the person should download this thing on the 8, what it means is that the person is going to get cracks. It's going to get tricked. It's going to get hitches. And the person is still going to complain. This has been tried multiple times and it's not working. So the company says, use a recent thing. For example, look at Windows. Imagine if somebody is using Windows 6, Windows 7, Internet Explorer 7 is no longer there. Okay, so there are certain things, like if a person goes to buy Nokia 96 right now, the person will not be able to use this thing on that Nokia 96 or Nokia 97 because these are very old phones, okay, or BlackBerry Bold. The person will not be able to use the thing on that, even if he has it. So, I mean, so nobody is saying that throw your BlackBerry Bold away. But the thing is that if you want to use this thing, because it's a backup solution, if you want to use this thing, iPhone has indicated that, not a company, it's iPhone company who has indicated that if you give us a software now, we don't want that software to work on old iPhones.
It's not all right. Company. Can I continue?
Yes, please.
Yes, so this one is concerning about new associates. And sometimes not even only new, but let's say some old associates too. What I've realized that most people, after signing, they have the energy. Like, you tell them what to do, like, they'll speak to, they'll monitor like 2, 3, 4 people be, like with energy, and then they'll speak to them. After speaking to them, they expect them to sign up. If they don't sign up, then they begin to give excuses. They will sleep. You call them, they'll tell you, my people cry, like they are not signing up. I say,
I'm sorry, you're making me laugh.
So as a leader and a professor and
okay. So this is a big thing, and I won't address it here. I won't lie to you. This is a whole training thing. Okay. And it is something that is deeply discussed at the leadership summit.
I think so.
The leadership summit is going to discuss on vision, it's going to discuss on wealth creation, other things that are not even got back up. But one of the things about God Backup that the Leadership Summit would define is mindset programming. Mindset programming. And another topic that will be fully discussed is whilst you are selling an idea to somebody, the person is also selling an idea to you. And this will be discussed. This is the same thing Elon Musk said he went through. This is the same thing Mark Zuckerberg went through. When he called 5 friends into the room of dormitory and he was speaking to them, 3 of them were giving him negativities that Facebook would never work. And the mindset he had is why he is today a billionaire. And this is a very deep concept. It's not only in GovAccount. It is everything. So many people don't like to be rejected. For example, look at an examination. Do you think people go to an exam with the intention of failing? No.
Never.
But then still, people what? Fail. When they fail, what do? They will have to push themselves and rewrite and get it. You don't fail once and then you say, I'm done. I'm not going to do it. Another one, natural one. Do you know that children, they fail all the time? They try to walk, they fall. They walk, they fall. And that child, without even a lot of knowledge, that child picks himself up and walks further and further again. It's instinct. The billionaires of the world, every single one. In fact, the last time Elon Musk was listening, he said he has failed 180 times. And he's writing a book on the power of failure. Failure emboldens you. So when people are not responding to you, it is because, one, you think people, for example, when you go into a football game, you go with the intention of winning. But if you go with the intention of winning, it means someone is going to lose. But at the end of the day, one wins and one loses, they shake hands. It's a mindset thing. And any leader, any achiever, any success person understands that you got to fail your way to success. You got to fail your way to success. You see, we see failure as bad, but achievers see failure as good. They see failing. For example, you are trying to log in, you are not getting the login. Why? Because you have not actually built your knowledge level, or you have forgotten your username and password, or you've lost something. That is why you are struggling. And so you got to fail. The login will not work. Then you try again and try again and try again. That is success. You see, success is not at the end. It's at the beginning. It is what topples. This is what me, ladies and gentlemen, for your information, I have failed more than all of you. People have rejected me, Dr. Kelly, than they have rejected all of you. Why? And let me tell you why. Because I've spoken to more people than all of you. Is there anybody here who can tell me that he has spoken to at least 1,000 people? But I can tell you that I've spoken to at least 1,005 people. But look at how many people have registered. Okay, only 100 are active. So am I going to be worried about the 1,004 who have not registered? Or I'm going to be happy with the 100 who have registered? Are you getting my point? My focus is not on the failure. I need more failures to be able to get, you know, some of it. My mindset, your mindset is what will help you. We would dissect this thing so well. And please, let me tell you something, eh? Anybody who thinks that he cannot do this thing will struggle in many things. That person will struggle in many things, I'm telling you. What this thing is doing is that it is giving you a different mindset of power mind, a different way to attack anything in your life. For example, do you know that some people go through some challenges in marriage and they want to leave? Small challenge, they want to leave. But that same challenge, the person will go and talk to another person. Then you say, hey, when are we going? This kind of thing, and you want to leave? Do you know my own? You, your partner is having malaria, you want to leave. Do you know that mine has HIV? So you come to now understand that, oh, wow. So what is making his own work? It is his ability to accept the failure and the pain. His ability. So you will see him and you think that everything is rosy, but he has honed the skills necessary to survive. This is mindset programming. We will teach them. It's a belief system. It's a negative system that is in many places in the world where when something is not working, forget it. When something is not working, you change your programming. You don't forget the thing. Because that same thing that is not working for you is working for somebody. Whatever you are losing in, someone is winning in. The problem is not the thing. The problem is your programming. Your programming. This course, and that is why the first training we'll do at the Leadership Summit is the power of the mind. The power of the mind. And I'm telling you, that is the difference between those who succeed and those who fail. So for those people that you are talking about, they are not committing themselves even to the training. The training here, for them to come and even listen to this small thing I've just said, they don't come. You see the number of people on the call, 60. They are not committed. You see, when we are doing Friday, you know how many people join? Over 100. And these are prospects. Prospects join. And now even this one rather, that is will build you, know. You see the people who are here? It means that the people who have registered, some of them are not even committed to their own rescue. Like they are not participating in their own financial rescue. But me, some of the leaders, you, we are always here. We are always here. We are the most talkative. We are always talking because we want to succeed and succeed well. So, Abisolo, this will be fully displayed, but I hope that explains the point you want to bring about.
Yeah, yes.
Okay.
I don't know if I can.
To you, and then you hold on. You come to your next point, but I'll go back to Enyanam because Enyanam wanted to make a point. Unless, Enyanam, your point is covered.
Yes, you're talking about it.
All right, okay. So let me go back to... So ladies and gentlemen, this is important, the GBU document. That document has 37 videos. If you tell me that I've read, then I know that you have watched the 37 videos. And I want to show you guys something. Those of you are not aware. I'm not going to the GBU document. I'm going to something else you probably has not even come into your mind. Ladies and gentlemen, are you aware... Okay, that there is another website that we always get our information from. There is a website we have, which is known as Knowledge Hub. Are you guys aware? The Knowledge Hub. The Knowledge Hub is an important webpage, and I want to show you something right here. And a lot of people are not going there. Dr. Dr. Belinda Odai went there and watched the video on, she watched the video on closing. Hi. And even though I did that video, because of the way she commented about that video, I decided to watch it again this morning. Oh boy, oh boy. Ladies and gentlemen, you want to watch the video. I'm going here to show. There are so many trainings that we have here. This is it. Dorothy, please, do they see?
Yeah, I can see.
There are so many trainings that, well, so let me just make you, I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. I want to make Dorothy, I want to make you so that you can mute those who are probably talking. And so this page, please add, how do you put it? When you're on the page, they say make that page part of your channels or something.
Subscribe.
Subscribe, yes, but also make it
and click on the notification.
Uh-huh. Something. Ladies and gentlemen, I beg you, if I were you, but that's also why I'm not you. If I were you, I'll go and watch all these videos. These trainings, look at the power of third party that Dr. Dorothy did. Look at believing with Dr. Fader. Look at unleash the power in you. Look at war winning through commitment. Okay. Look at the service of God backup, the most important element, the art of closing. Okay. What is your compelling reason? The why. Important trainings that have been done here, desire. All of these things, ladies and gentlemen, are there for a person to activate your. You will see that this will help. Okay. So please, this channel, together with the one we always use for Sunday, are very important. Please get these things and watch these videos. It will save you. It will save you. It will lift up, because especially there are some of these trainings. For example, look at this one, placement in God backup. Placement. You have not watched the placement. Look at the drawing even here. Go and watch the placement. You see how much placement can really, really help. And then several of these live videos that we have done. This is what is making some people do better. You know, sometimes a person can join the business, then all of a sudden, boom, 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 he's over. Then you have been here for 5 months. You say, hey, what am I doing wrong? What you are doing wrong is that you are not watching this video. You are not watching the skills needed to power yourself. All right, let me go back to you, Enyanam. What is one of the other mistakes that you have observed that people are doing in this thing? What is another one?
One mistake is people think they can do their business in secret. This is one of the greatest mistakes an entrepreneur can make in their business. That doing business.
What do you mean by they are doing their business in secret?
It's like they don't want to show their face. They don't want to let people around them know about it. They virtually hide. It's like they are secret service people.
Hold on. I want to understand. What do you mean by they don't want people to know? Because they are already prospecting people. So what do you mean by they don't want people to know?
Well, one thing I check on every team member is their status. What are they putting on their status? You see people who are in this business for months. You will never see them putting anything. I'm not saying go and put compliment there, but at least see people, attract people to ask you questions. This is okay. What I don't.
And you know, somebody has put their bond. You have put there because they don't know how. They don't know how to do it.
They have to come for the training.
The fact is that they said save your leader's numbers. And tell them to save you. That's what the leaders do and follow you.
So, Bondi.
And you get.
Yeah, go ahead.
And you get to know that we don't only post about God backup, we post about other things that make people watch you. If it's one way, people get bored easily. Put something that would excite someone, that will advise someone, that will educate someone, at times to even give them energy. They may be down, but just coming to your status. I have people who say, my status is like home for them. They come and they get relief when they are stressed out. You see teammates putting death, accident on their... The world is already negative. You don't need to tell anybody.
Like people, like accident with blood, then they'll share it on their status.
Yes. You are supposed to be positive, to give hope to people, not depression.
Okay.
How we talk on that? That is the second thing.
I'll come back to that. Bondu, you said that they don't know how. So, Bondu, this is what you should do. Check the status of your leaders. You know what some of the guys do? They check the status of the leader. And then they'll say, please, can you send me this video? Can you send me this? Let me tell you one thing you can always post. Anytime somebody becomes bronze, silver, you know, copper, and they share it on the page, take it and share it on your status. Finished. Share. Go back and go and share all the bronzes, the coppers and the silvers and the gold. The people that, you know, go and share it. You just share that for now. That's the first one. Second, go to the Facebook group. We are all on the Facebook group. Godbacker Facebook group. Go there. There are pictures and information about Godbacker. Put it there. Share information. Please, I've done a video on this thing. This video I did is one of the important videos I did for Godbacker in my early days, where Chris and Tommy were supposed to do that training. And I was replaced to do that training. And I showed so many things you can share on your social media. So many. For example, belief, things about fear, how to take out fear, how to venture where angels fear to tread, how to try, even if it's not going to work, how to be an entrepreneur, the importance of risks. So if I were you, I'll type risks in Google and I'll go to Google Images. And then everything about risks, I'll read and pick about three of them and I'll share. Things about fear, which can paralyze you, I'll share. Okay? Things about entrepreneurship, I'll share. Things about positive mindset, I'll share. So get those things. Please go and watch that video. Go and watch. Don't sit down and wait. Go to the channel I just showed you and watch all the videos. Watch all the videos. You can't expect me to come and give you the pictures, give you somebody's bronze, which you have seen with your naked eye. Somebody's bronze, you see with your naked eye, you say that I, the tattoo, I should come and send it that bronze before you share it on your status. No way. You got to participate in your own rescue. You got to participate. You can't sit down. If you want to be copper before you end up this month, you can become copper. You can. Two people. You can. Do you know how many things I share on my status? 20. At least 20 things on my status. You got to share for people to now see that you yourself, you believe in what you are saying. Go and watch the video on closing. There are some here, they are not closed. Some of you are not closed. When somebody says that, are you sure this thing can pay you?
No.
Me, I'm only wondering. You are not closed. You yourself, you are not closed. You are wondering at this stage. You register something, you are not so convinced, else you'll be making money for what you have. They see other people doing it, okay? But you are not doing it. They see other people doing it, you are not doing it. And that is why they have recognized that they don't have to engage you anymore. That is why when you call them, they don't pick. That's why when you send them messages, they are not replying you. Because they can see that you yourself, you are not convinced enough. You are not making noises enough. Like they know others are making the noises. They watch, they see it, they hear it, but you are not. The same people you have spoken to, if I go and talk to them right now, some of them are going to register because the energy and the vim and the passion and the conviction that I have, you don't have that. You don't have that, okay? And some of you know it. And so that is why you want to build yourself. Build it. Nobody will be doing everything for you. This is going to pay you, but you got to make a decision for your life. You got to decide that you are going to make this thing work. Okay, we're coming to the end. Okay, we'll continue the other orientational information. What is the last thing you want to tell the team? Let me go to you, Dr. Dorothy.
I think I want to tell everybody who joined this call that, look, you are a leader. And the first thing I learned when I joined this project first was, as a leader, you lead yourself first before you can lead others. It hit me hard. I mean, I was just starting. I didn't know much about the thing, but the project. But once you have built yourself with all this that we have said, there's no way anybody can take any of the skills from you. The skills are yours to practice forever. So once you join, in as much as we would love to make the income early and make it fast and let it happen fast and everything fast, yes, you have to have a short-term urgency to this, but have a long-term mentality attached to it. Like, you're not doing this for the next 3 months and then you're off. This is something you are committed to, that you are building yourself to build wealth. Wealth doesn't happen over a short period. There's so much mindset you should put to this. And don't play yourself small. If you start by feeling that, hey, will it work? Hey, will it work? It is going to be like that. Your brain expands to the ideas you give it. So if you're already in and you see yourself as a black diamond, your mind will attract everything black diamond. There's a meeting, you are there. You are not reminded before you attend. There's a call, you are there. You are calling everybody to come along. There's a training, you are there. Like, I've attended so many trainings, but I still keep attending training because every one of them is different. Every Sunday is different. Every Friday is different. Every Tuesday is different. Dr. Kerry says, yes, the same content, but the way it's delivered is different. And he adds on new things every day. So you're just there because there's every time I learn something new about even how to present it differently.
Before you continue, let me just quickly chip in. I'm putting my hat this way for a reason. Ladies and gentlemen, watch something, even this way for a reason. I don't even know how to. Let me tell you something.
The side.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you some secrets. This is very important. Very, very important. Have you observed that when you invite someone to come for the presentation and they come for the presentation, then you the person tells you that I've come, okay? I've loved everything. I'll put things together and I'll register. Have you observed that when the person says that, you don't even know what else to say? Like, he has listened. Let me tell you something you should do. Invite the person again for the next week. Invite the person again for the next week. Invite the person again for the next week. Again for the next week. Again for the next. Because let me tell you something anyway. If he becomes a member, what is he going to do anyway? Is he not going to come every week? Is he not going to come every week? Mm-hmm. So why do you invite the person only once? And then you say that he has listened to the presenter. Ask, do you know why we go to church every day, every week? Do you go to church once a week and then say, I'm baptized, I've stopped going? You see why I attend the thing that way? See, there is knowledge and there is wisdom. The wisdom is that you got to let a person attend that training. So what are you going to say for the person to attend the training the next time? You remember the training that the presentation you attended? The speaker wants to tell you something again this week. There is something else that they want to tell everybody that came. There is something else they want to tell everybody that came. There is something else that will be revealed again this week. There is something else that is going to be given to you this week. There is something else. There is something else. There is something else. So every week, even though the person has not paid, you are making the person attend the presentation every week. I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit will get a person. That person will now be exorcised. Whatever demonic thing is in the person will be exorcised. You see, the thing is that it is like what Jesus said. When you go and sow seed, you got to keep watering it, water it, water it, water it until it grows. But what you do is that you invite a person to come for presentation one Friday. And then now the person, I've listened to the presentation, I'm done. Oh, are you inviting me for the same presentation again? No, I'm inviting you for that same day, but a different presentation. And when the person comes, the person's brain is expanded because you see, the person has listened though, but he's limited in knowledge. You cry, you are limited in knowledge yourself. You can't even present what I present. You are limited. So you got to invite a person again and invite a person again. But you see, you stop. So that invitation is what we call follow-up. follow up. You are following up. Other than that, you see that you have nothing else to tell the person. And I finished though. They have attended though. What should I do again?
They are not signing though.
They are not signing up. Oh. Invite them again. And invite them again. And invite them again. Because the more they are exposed to the magnet, the more they are magnetized by the conditions they are seeking. I'm telling you, the more they come, the more they join, the more they listen, the more they read. For all you know, the first one he did, he just joined in the last minute. He just joined in the last minute. He didn't even hear anything. In fact, when he joined, he was also watching football. When he joined, he was cleaning the children. So he's not really, really eating the incognito. That's why I say he's not gotten the spirit. But the more he attends. Look, let me tell you something. There is someone, he had to attend the training, now for 5 months before he eventually decided to register. He said that, dog, the more I was attending this, your presentation, that was when I was getting the bigger understanding. But you invited a person, he came last Sunday and you stopped. You didn't invite again this Sunday. You're not inviting again next Sunday. You're not invite every time. I want to put that on record. So that you don't leave them. You don't leave them. If you think it's the same, they will think it's the same. If you think that what is coming is a completely new thing, they will think that what is coming is a completely new thing. And they will come again and again and again. Because even though it looks like it's the same, it is new. It is new. Because they will hear new things. See, they will hear new things that will change their psyche. Because the closing information we put there is jollof. It's jollof. Sometimes it's not all about God back up. It is the kind of collectivity of information that we are vomiting to people. You see that, for example, when we are talking about, you got to take chances. You got to take risks. Pregnancy is risky. COVID-19 is risky. He heard that thing last time. But today he's hearing it differently. He said, it's true. Even my pregnancy, it was a risk, but eventually I didn't get to the first one. I had a miscarriage. But the second one, I tried, but it worked. This is the time that thing has hit her. But the first time he came, didn't even hear that message. You got to invite and bring the person to the altar every time. I'm telling you, this is jollof. And that is why many of your people are not registering, because you are not inviting them all the time. The same people, you got to invite them. Until they register, you got to invite them. Let them begin to enjoy this thing. So, Anyama, what do you want to say to us before we close?
Okay. So, Vossi recently, I think 2 days ago, posted something on intelligence. He said the intelligence is the ability of your mind to expand with the new information that you've gathered. Lots of us are getting information, but we are not expanding our mind. We are stuck in how we see things. There are a lot of new trainees. I keep telling people that this business is not like what you've done previously, if you've ever been involved. And if this is a new, you should even learn more. It should help you learn more. Because if you don't expand your mind, you realize that you be at one place and you can't move forward. It's very important that we keep renewing our mind. The Bible didn't just say it like that. It said what? We should renew our mind. It means that you are getting information, but you would have to change your previous mind.
Mm-hmm.
Training is very important. And not just coming to listen and going to sleep. Utilizing it. People are they call, they will listen and go back and do the same thing. But it is by using it that changes things in us. If we are able to use this document every day, is being posted. As soon as people ask me, I tell them, go back. I've done it today. I did it to someone more than 5 times. Because I know every question the person is asking is in that document. So I keep telling, as soon as they ask, I say, you haven't read this thing. You have not read. Go back and read. Because if you keep feeding people with fish, they will get rotten at times. Teach people how to fish. If they learn how to fish, then they can go to any river or any stream and get their own fish. But the fish will be rotten if you keep handing over fresh fish to them. So this is what we shouldn't be doing things for people. They need to do it themselves, even as leaders. Yeah. And it will help.
And for the, thank you, for the older generations, those who always tell themselves, I'm not tech, I don't know how to do technology, please stop that thing. Stop inviting negativities into your life. I don't know how to do tech things. I don't know how to do, you are using a smartphone, please. You are using a smartphone. You are smart. You are smart. That's why you are using a smartphone. So stop this, I don't know how to. See, Dr. Mrs. Rosa Mwating, okay? She's over, I forgot her name, she's over 70 or so, you know? And yet she is here. She is on Zoom. Do you know what that means? Stop belittling who you are. You too were created in God's image, okay? So don't say that, I don't know how to. If you don't know, you learn. If you don't know, you learn. You learn. You learn. But okay, so you don't know how to do it, so you don't want to earn money. So when we give you the 1 million, sorry, I don't know how to earn, so please, I don't know how to. You see that thing? You want to earn, and so you want to learn. You want to earn, so you want to learn. And then remove the L, then you earn. That is life. Even the son had to learn. So please, do not belittle your capacity to do more. Do not belittle your capacity to learn more. Do not belittle your capacity to have more. If you learn more, you have more. Guaranteed, full stop, and learn this thing. And we are all learning. We are all learning. We'll be coming here and do this thing, okay? And then we'll continue. Do this thing on Saturday. And avail yourself to this training because it will build your mindset. See, even when you are here, see how positive you feel. See the kind of knowledge you just learned today. Look at it. What if we have not done this? It means that you have lacked knowledge. You have lacked knowledge. So that's why we have to appreciate the people who come here and voice out knowledge to us. Because the only thing you can say to us is thank you. That is it. That is it. That is the only thing you can say. But you see, when you watch, you have to type some. You have to say thank you. Thank you, Dr. Dorothy. Thank you, you know, Mrs. Onyenan. Thank you, Dr. Kelly. Thank you, Dr. Bisolo. That way, you two are contributing your quota to the knowledge belt. There is more happiness in giving. What have you given? Have you typed thank you there? There's more happiness in giving. What have you given? Have you typed thank you there? You have not spoken. You have not typed thank you. You see the difference. You see why you are not receiving. You see why you are not receiving. Because you are not giving. Because you are not giving. Because you are not giving. That is it. I know the more I sacrifice for people, the more I'll get. I know this. It's a principle. Whether you love God, whether you serve God, you don't serve God, you'll get it. And that is it. Abisolo, are you here? I want you to conclude. What do you want to tell us last? Abisolo? Abisolo, what do you want to tell us finally? One thing about him is that sometimes he'll be listening to us and he'll be doing third-party calls. He'll be listening and then he'll be doing third-party calls at the same time. All right, so ladies and gentlemen, let's end by saying that you are your own panel of defense. You are your own panel. You either win in this or you perish in this. And please remember this. If there's a better option, we will all not be here. Never forget that. If there is a better option, this Zoom will not be organized. If there is a better option, this Zoom, you will not be here. I won't be here. But currently, if you think there is a better option than what we have now, you let us know. We'll come and be part of that better option. But right now, this is our only, not only, but our better option now. That is why we are doing this whilst we are doing other ones. If you ever find a better option, you will leave this. I'm telling you, if you find something that will reward you more than this, and they will be paying you like $10,000, I guarantee you will leave this thing. You're not even come here. But until you find that, stay on this, because this will reward you $10,000 if you stay on the course. It will reward you, like it is doing to some of us. So take the advantage of your advantage. Take advantage of your advantage and make it work. Make it. You see, let me tell you why you will never be able to complain that it didn't work, because it is working for others. It is working in the same environment. It's working for them. So why don't you ask them, what is it you are doing that is working for you? For example, today, I've spoken to about 44 people. That's today alone. I've spoken to about 44 people. How many have you spoken to? Oh, by the way, when I say I've spoken to about 44 people, I didn't spend more than 2 minutes on each one. I just call them and say, hi, Kofi, I have some incredible news for you. Do you want to hear it today or you want to hear it next year? That's what I tell them. I have incredible news. Do you want to hear it today or you want to hear it next year? He will always say today. If he says today, I said, okay, no problem. Okay, I'm going to do a presentation. There's going to be a presentation that will reveal this incredible news on Friday, 6 p.m. Join me. It's up to you. Whether you join me or not, it's up to you. Okay? It is going to help you. It will bless you. Take it. And I leave the person. Whether the person joins or doesn't join, I don't care, because there are other 39 people I'm talking to. That's how it works. He joins, he doesn't join. That's what I'm worried. Hey, I'm sorry. Hey, you invited all my people, they didn't join. You invited few people. You invited few people. That's why they didn't join. If you invite 10 people, nobody will join. We will invite more people. Yesterday, I spoke to 88 people. 88 people a day. Why? Because I know why it is important to speak to more people, because not many will come. So if I speak to 5, 10, hope, it won't happen. But if I speak to 20, 30, 40, I know many will come. So I need to do that. It's just a matter of inviting them. And it's a very powerful invitation without giving details. That's what we do. Inviting without giving details. Inviting without giving details. But you see, some of you, you want to give all the details. That's why the thing becomes basa, nyama, plenty difficult for you. That's it. All right. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. If there is a question, I know. Yeah, Geraldine.
I just wanted to tell everybody who has not yet registered to register for the 7th December. It's going to be more than this. Everything you need to succeed, not just in Go Back Up, in your own life will be shared there. And that framework that the billionaires have, by the time you leave the seminar, the summit, your mind will be, Dr. Keo will say, Baba Hayes. And the mental gymnastics would have started. I hope I said it well. So yeah. Please, the link is up. Register and pay up. I mean, just get on board. The seats are limited. So if you've not done that yet, you still have just a couple of days to start it, to get it running on that Saturday. So we are getting pumped up. I mean, this is just the beginning of what you see there. So register now.
Yeah, I don't force anybody to come. If you know you will come, you know you will come. Okay. Even if there are 5 people, they will get all that they need to have to become Sapphire by the end of this year. It's full stop. You see it. When Abisolo joined Go Back Up just a month ago, you know, 2 months ago, you know, we arranged that you will become Emerald before the end of August. It's happened. Okay. And you will see him getting to Ruby next month. The point is that you got to believe in this. When you avail yourself to all of these activities, you become pumped up. Some of you are not growing up yet. The reason is because it is the first time you are now becoming knowledgeable in this. For some of you, you are not really, for example, you are not presenting. Most of you here are not presenting. You are not presenting. But you see, those of us who are growing further, we are presenting. So at the event, there's a whole 1 hour devoted on presenting. There's a whole 1 hour devoted to how do you present in an incisive way for people to listen to you. And then the latest presentation slides will be given to people. And then we teach people how to present. We will even demonstrate for people to go and present. That presentation skills is a super skill. So please be there, because it will change everything in that regard. And it's the last that we are doing this year. It's the last meeting. It's the last physical meeting that we are doing this year. It is going to change minds and help people to boost. In fact, we are even going to teach you on how to multiply your income. Not even Go Back Up income. Your income in life. We are going to teach you how to multiply it. All right. Thank you all very much indeed. Thank you, every single person who have been on the call. Thank you, the older generations who have been around or let me say the younger, older generation, you know, those above the 50s, I love to see all of you here, and I can see all of you have been here. This is incredible. It's lovely to have you. Madam Agata Mensa, 59 years old, or 61 of them. Mrs. Amwaten being here, Bondu being around here, you people are really making a difference. You see, if people in their 50s and 60s are hungry for more, and you, Opele Chinkafa Nawele Bombombo, you are in your 20s and 30s, you don't want to be more, then my father will say, fire burn you. Then you have the one, you have caused your own situation. Okay. People who have reached that level of life even want to be more. Not you. You deserve to be more. Thank you very much indeed. Have a wonderful evening. We'll see you again on Friday. That is the next invitation. That Friday one is for everybody. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you, Dorothy. Thank you, Anyanam. Thank you, Abisodo. Bye-bye.